Coming up, with the recent one-year anniversary of Microsoft Teams, we're going to take a look at the latest updates, including its evolution from a persistent chat-based workspace to an integrated hub for teamwork with complete meeting and calling capabilities built in, as well as new ways to bring your favorite apps into Teams and more. Also, if you're an IT admin, we're going to give you a first look at the unified experience to manage Microsoft Teams, along with Skype for Business going forward. Once again by Ann Michels from the Teams team. Welcome and congrats on the one-year milestone.
Thank you. It's so good to be back on the show.
So from its humble origins of a chat-based work environment, it's now even more of an integrated hub for teamwork. In fact, we just announced that more than 200,000 organizations are using Teams globally.
We've really been focused on delivering Microsoft Teams as the hub for teamwork that enables you and your teams to be more productive by giving you a single and secure location that brings together everything you need as a team. For example, chat, this is our core experience in Teams. Meetings, you can schedule and join meetings. Calls, Microsoft Teams is now your primary enterprise calling client. You can also share and collaborate on files, and you can bring in your favorite tools into Teams. We've especially been working on a few areas. First, how can we broaden your collaboration experience? Second, the extensibility of the platform so that you can bring in your apps in more ways. And we've also been working on improving the overall meeting and calling experience and on bringing all the Skype for Business online capabilities into Teams.
So Microsoft Teams has really come a long way. In fact, it's something that I personally use every day. But before we go too deep into the updates, let's catch everyone up on the core aspects and core functionality of Microsoft Teams.
Sure. So Teams is built around chat. I'm here in a team, and teams are organized by channels, which you can think of as topics or areas that you work on within a team. Within a channel, you can chat, and all chat messages are threaded and persistent, so you have a full record of the conversation over time.
And this is really important because then you can invite somebody late to a team, or maybe you can join a team late and then get up to speed with all the conversations that have already happened.
We also integrate fun and engaging ways to communicate, like emojis or GIFs or stickers that you might use in your everyday social interactions. When you share a file in a channel, then that file gets uploaded automatically to SharePoint, and you can see all your files directly here at the top at the Files tab. But you cannot only view a file in Teams, but you can also edit the file directly here from the experience. And back in my Conversations tab, if I click on the camera icon, I can start an ad hoc meeting directly here from the channel. And when I go to the Meetings tab, I can see all of my meetings in one view, including the one set up in Outlook, and I can also schedule a new one if I want to.
So some of the things that we're hearing is a lot of people can spend their entire workday within Teams. They've got all their files, their apps, the communications they need to make with other team members, all in one place. But why don't we dive into the updates?
So let me first show you how we are broadening your collaboration experience. Many of you work with people outside of your organization, like agencies or partners. And to enable you to collaborate with these people, we have added guest access in Teams. You can see here I'm in a chat, in a channel, that actually has several external members. So for example, here at the top, I can see that this team has guests, and also every external member is clearly labeled as a guest. And if you want to add another guest, you can do that by clicking on Add Member, just as you would add an internal coworker. All the guest needs is an email address.
Okay, so if you hop on over to my machine, I've received your invite. I'm gonna go ahead and click on the Accept button. And here you can see it's logging me into Teams. The nice thing is I can be signed in not only with my own organization, but also the second organization as a guest, in this case, with only access to the team that you've invited me to.
Exactly. Well, welcome to my team here, Jeremy.
Thank you.
Just one thing to notice for you is your guest access is scoped just to my team and the other teams that you might have been invited to. Well,
right.
In fact, Jeremy is obviously very eager to be part of the team and to get engaged. So he's already sending me a chat message here. And a nice thing that we have added is that I can now respond to the chat message directly from the Toast notification.
Right. One of the things that we can also do as an IT admin is we can control the actual guest experience. And you can learn more about all the controls that you have available to you at the link shown. Now, you mentioned earlier that we've built Teams really as a means to be a platform that you can customize with extensibility and integrated experiences across other SaaS services that you use within Teams. So what can we do there?
There are different ways how you can use apps in Teams. Most people will know that you can integrate an app as a tab. By clicking on the plus sign, I can add an app like SurveyMonkey or a Power BI dashboard, and then it is easily accessible for everybody at the top of the channel. We also have bots and teams, so you can add mention a bot like GrowBot, which gives kudos to your coworkers. So this is just a really nice way to show appreciation to the people that you're working with. To make it easier for you to discover the apps that are available in Teams, we have added a new store. In here, I can search for apps by name or also by category, like, for example, analytics and BI, or project management, or by integration type, like bots, connectors, or I could also add a tab directly from here. But sometimes you don't want to see all the information from an app. So we've included a new personalized view of your app where you can see only the information that is relevant for you. For example, here, I can see all the planner tasks that have been assigned to me across my various teams.
And this is great. Since Teams is really a chat-based experience, are we doing anything that will actually connect to some of these apps right from within chat?
So let me show you some of the new ways how you can interact with an app in Teams. You can now include information from an app directly in a conversation, just like you would add an emoji or a GIF. So you can bring information in from an app, like for example, an item from Visual Studio, with a simple click directly into a chat or a channel conversation. So you don't have to include a screenshot or hyperlink to that information anymore. But what if I now want to add somebody here to my chat who is an actual expert on drones? So another way how to interact with apps is the new command box. For example, here, I can type /who knows about drones, and then who searches the team conversation history and the org chart for people that are talking about drones.
Right, and if we flip back over to my machine, one of the things that we can do here is also navigate or do other commands within Teams. Here, I'm gonna click /call, and you can see I can call Alex, for example, or as I said, you can navigate as well, so I'm gonna type /goto, and that will allow me to go to any of the channels then in this case that I'm a member of.
Yes, it's a very powerful shortcut tool to navigate Teams and to take quick actions. And back here now on my machine, I can see the results that Who has returned. So I have a list of people that talk about drones, and Lee is actually a person that I know. So let me go ahead and jump back to my chat conversation. And now I'll go ahead and add Lee to that conversation. And a nice thing that we have added is I cannot just share the conversation history with Lee, but I can also decide how much I want to share.
It looks like in this case, you're gonna share all of the conversation history.
Exactly. And a few more things that we have added in chat is that you can now mute a chat if you don't want to receive notifications anymore. You can hide a chat, or you could even leave a chat if it's not important to you anymore.
Right, and the big news in September is that we announced Microsoft Teams will be the core communications client for Office 365. So what have you done there to really enhance the communication capabilities?
We did. We've now started to bring all the Skype for Business online capabilities into Teams to give you a complete meeting and calling solution. So I have a meeting here. Let me just go ahead and jump here into the meeting. And when I join, I get to choose whether to join with video or audio, and I can also select my devices. So I don't have to worry about joining with background noise anymore. I just joined here from the desktop app. But when you invite somebody to a meeting, they can also use their mobile phone if they're on the go, or they could join directly from the browser. They don't even need to have Teams. You can invite anybody with an email address to your meetings.
So one of the really nice things here is that you don't need anything installed on your machine in order to join that online meeting. No desktop apps, no browser plugins. But to switch gears here, often I'm inside of a meeting. I want to be able to share content out. How can I do that from within Teams?
That's an area that we have especially been focused on to make sure that your meeting experience in Teams is better than the typical remote meeting experience, where you can lose a lot of time connecting to a meeting, then extending your display and sharing your desktop. That can take way too long to get set up. With Teams, we are focused on streamlining this experience. So I'm here now in a meeting, and it is very easy for me to control what content I want to share. And that could be a file, or it could also be my entire desktop. I see, Jeremy, you're actually here in the meeting with me. Why don't you go ahead and try to share content from your phone?
Okay, so let's try this out. I'm gonna go ahead and click on the ellipses here, and hopefully you'll be able to see this in your screen. There it is. Okay, so first I'm gonna share my mobile screen so that you can see what's on there. And I've got some pictures I've been working on with the Surface team. I'm just gonna scroll through a few of those, and you can see that. But the nice thing is, because I'm connected to the cloud with my phone, I can even go to all the office experiences here like Excel. And now I've got the Excel app, and you can see all the different mechanics videos that we're working on. And it's right there. And so that means I don't need to have my laptop with me in order for me to be able to share my screen with you or another device in order to share all the content I have. It's all stored in the cloud, and it's all accessible right here from the phone. So it really extends that screen sharing experience beyond the desktop, which is awesome if you're on the go. But what if you're not able to join the meeting? You're maybe late to it if you're double booked. Can I join that meeting afterwards?
Yes, you can. I will give you an early look at cloud recording, one of our key new features and the first step in our mission to transform collaboration and communication through AI and Teams. So I'm here in a meeting, and I can start a recording simply by clicking on Start Recording. And then when I'm done, I just leave the meeting. This will be familiar to you if you have recorded meetings in Skype in the past. But with Teams, we've even gone a step further. Because recordings are automatically saved and uploaded to Microsoft Stream. So you don't have to worry about where it's saved. It's all taken care of for you. So I actually have here a meeting that I recorded last week. And as it's all automatically transcribed, I can also go ahead and turn on closed captioning.
And this is really great in terms of a use case for AI because it's adding a transcript there. From an accessibility standpoint, it makes it much better. And we're using things like cognitive services and voice to text to really bring that transcript and that caption file straight into the meeting that's happened. So switching gears again, why don't we talk about some of the call integration? Because a lot of folks are maybe using their landlines or PSTN lines. We've done some integration with Teams to make all of that work as well, right?
Yes, so Teams is now also your primary enterprise calling client. Teams has a full cloud PBX client, so you can call the people in your organization, or well, actually, you could call anybody else on the planet who has a phone number. So from the calling tab, you can access all of your contacts. I can see previous or missed calls, and I can also access all of my voicemails, including transcriptions. It's all available for me in one place. But while we all know that calling is much more than just dial tone, enterprises really need complex call flow support. So we also support advanced call functions like call queues and call transferring. For this functionality, you need a calling plan, which is available in many countries around the world. And we're constantly increasing our global coverage. So you can learn more about that at the link shown.
So I know we have a lot of IT admins that are watching that administer things like Teams and Skype for Business. And going back to your roots in terms of the admin center, are there things that we've done here in terms of bringing that unified experience together with Teams and Skype for Business?
Definitely. We just rolled out the first version of the Microsoft Teams and Skype for Business admin center. This is a new unified portal which provides you with the ability to manage Microsoft Teams and Skype for Business in one place. The portal has completely been redesigned to make it easy to use, and it also provides you with more functionality. For example, in the new admin center, you can manage Teams at the user level, or you could also create messaging policies. This is just the first version. We will include additional workloads over time.
Now, this is a really great set of updates, Anne. Thank you for joining us, and really great to see all the progress on Microsoft Teams for users and admins. But where can people go to get started?
So it's really easy to get started with Teams. Simply go to the link shown. And if you're an admin, if you want to try the first version of the new admin center, please go to admin.teams.microsoft.com and log in with your Office 365 account.
And if you haven't already, become a subscriber to Microsoft Mechanics. Follow us on Twitter. That's all the time we have for today's show. Thank you for watching. We'll see you next time.